judged. I worried that when she was gone, I'd be like a ship adrift at sea. But she left me with a lot of strengths. I'm definitely the product of my mother's upbringing. She grew up in the middle of a forest in northern Michigan, isolated from other children, but surrounded by birds, squirrels, and deer. As I grew up in Hawaii and the South Pacific, she taught me to be amazed by the simple things in nature, such as a baby bird or the shape of a flower. From her, I learned adaptability. When my mother fell in love with a pilot, she couldn't have imagined how far life would take her from everything that was familiar. My father took a job with a small island hopper airline in Hawaii in the 60s, landing my mother in a world of insane food prices, poisonous toads, centipedes, swarming termites, and bird-sized cockroaches. She desperately missed her home in Michigan, but she made the best of it without complaint. In 1969, my father moved us to the Mariana Islands to start a new airline, and my mother was taken even further away from all that was familiar. The extreme heat and humidity were hard on her, but she stoically did her best to survive in an exotic land with a new language and culture, strange food, life without a telephone or even a mailing address, and only one TV channel. She found ways to keep us fed during regular power outages that sometimes went on for days. And when the power goes out, of course, there's no running water. My mother taught me survival skills. Together, we weathered several super typhoons with winds of over 200 miles an hour, in which we lost everything we owned and did without running water for weeks and without electricity for months. We lived mostly on canned vegetables, and I got really good at cooking a pot of rice on a hibachi. My mother loved animals. We always had a house full of pets, dogs, cats, birds, rabbits, and fish. She was always rescuing orphaned baby animals and nursing injured animals back to health. Some of our more exotic house guests included coconut crabs, fruit bats, and a shrew named Linus. Before she married, my mother was a nurse. She taught me basic first aid, but also how to care for someone with compassion. She was an excellent cook and housekeeper. She made sure I learned skills in the kitchen and how to do all the household chores. It was only later I realized that through her example, I'd also learned that there is joy to be found in serving others unselfishly. More than anything, my mother loved being a mother. We never had much money, but she always managed to make something out of nothing. Every year she threw big themed birthday parties for me and my brother, making decorations and favors from whatever she could find. She found lots of free activities for us to get involved in and spent much of her time driving us to those activities. Our house is where all the neighborhood kids hung out. We had lots of sleepovers. As I got older, there were many nights she stayed up all night helping me type my homework and term papers. In her later years, my mother spent most of her time organizing thousands of family photos and putting them into albums, which she would then spend hours looking through. Shortly before she died, she asked me to enlarge and frame a photo of my parents, my brother, and I that was taken just before I left home at 18. I always hated that photo, but it reminded her of the last time our family was intact. Starting this summer, I was faced with an empty nest, and I found myself also looking through thousands of photos, and I have enlarged on the wall a picture of my three kids that was taken the last time our family was all together 2 years ago. My mother loved her two children and four grandchildren fiercely. She had a strong faith in God and prayed for us with every breath. I believe she had God's ear, and her prayers always felt like a safety net to me. Now that she's gone, I know it's up to me to step into her role as the family matriarch, and I hope I can do half the job she did.
story. My apologies.